five pieces of advice for every Muslim when a loved one passes away. In Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, every soul shall taste death. Death is an undeniable fact. Time after time, we as human beings lose ourselves in this temporary world. Thus, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sends us signs and reminder. We see our loved ones pass on from this world. The loss of a loved one is undoubtedly a grieving matter, and only those who have experienced it can know the true depth of pain it causes when it strikes. And there is a way prescribed in Islam that how to deal with such losses. There are five pieces of advice which can help. Number one, sabr, patience. Nobody can be given a blessing better and greater than patience. One of the toughest things is to be patient when a loved one passes. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Quran, surely Allah is with the patient. Through patience, one can seek Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's assistance. And Allah will never burden a soul more than it can take. And Prophet peace be upon him informed us that when is it that true patience is recorded? Prophet peace be upon him said, verily, the patience is at the first stroke of calamity. And observing patience doesn't mean that we can't cry or feel down when loved one passes. Prophet peace be upon him had tears in his eyes when his son Ibrahim passed away. And he, Prophet peace be upon him, said, we are very sad for your death, O Ibrahim. And what are those things that we cannot do when loved one passes? These things are crying excessively, hitting oneself, tearing the clothes, questioning Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's decree, and causing any self-harm. All of this is strictly forbidden, and by doing these, we lose a great reward which comes with being patient. In Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, but give glad tidings to as-sabirun, the patient ones, who when afflicted with calamity, say, truly to Allah we belong, and truly to Him we shall return. They are those on whom are the salawat, who are blessed and will be forgiven from their Lord, and they are those who receive His mercy, and it is they who are the guided ones. And after patience, the second thing that will help is dua. Dua, supplications. Making dua for our loved ones who have passed. When our loved ones were alive, they make duas for our well-being. Now that they have moved on to the next world, now they rely upon our duas. They are in desperate need of our duas. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Quran, call upon me, I will respond to you. Make dua for the loved ones' forgiveness. Especially, the children should make dua for their parents. Prophet peace be upon him said, a man's status will be raised in paradise and he will ask, how did I get here? He will be told, by your son's prayers for forgiveness for you. And after dua and prayers, the third thing that will help is sadqa, charity. And other beneficial thing a Muslim should do for their deceased loved ones is to give charity on their behalf. And this is a proven sunnah. Ibn Abbas reported that the mother of Sa'd ibn Ubaidah died when he was away from her. And he said, O Messenger of Allah, my mother has died and I am away from her. Will it benefit her anything if I give in charity on her behalf? He said, yes. Then he said, then I ask you to be my witness that I am giving my garden al-mikhraf. And in Quran it is said, those who spend in charity will be richly rewarded. And after the charity, the fourth thing that will help is forgiveness and aiding. In life, we may have a number of disagreements and they can lead to holding grudges with one another. Forgiving the deceased of any wrong they may have done to you is a huge gift one can give to them. By letting go of a grudge or even something they owed you, you are showing a trait of being merciful, which leads to Allah being merciful to you. The Muslim should also aid in the funeral too, for this is one of the rights of a Muslim upon another Muslim, and aid the close relatives of the deceased at their time of difficulty. And after forgiving and aiding, the fifth thing that will help is reflection. Finally, take these moments of pondering over the reality of this life, and that we all will be soon joining the dead. We are told to remember the death often and even encouraged to visit the graveyards. And don't let the shaitan to keep you busy with the worldly stuff. Rather remind yourself that death can call any time. This life is quite limited. One day we all have to leave this world. No one is going to live forever. Even prophets, Allah's beloved people have died. Today, your loved one is in the grave. Tomorrow you can be there. So prepare yourself before that day